Trevor Shikiba can help us get there.
Yes.
Hi, Trevor.
Good. How are y'all?
We're good.
So at the end of the year, I mean, people reflect back on the year, right? But like, let's say you've made some pretty major financial boo-boos. I mean, can you recover from them?
You can always recover. It's never too late. So you want to start, well, actually, you want to finish this year really strong and then start off 2018 on the right foot. And really, the first tip I have here, or the financial mistake you don't want to make, is living at or above your means. And I'm not sure what else to say here, but
right. If
you are not able to live below your means, you're never simply going to build wealth and be able to achieve your financial goals. So my action item here is develop that budget, right? Really analyze that and start living below your means so you can save.
Well, exactly. If you're not, like, how could you save if you're spending more than you actually make, right?
Yeah, exactly. And I actually had a conversation with my lovely wife, Christina, on this, who's the spender of our relationship. Surprise.
I know how she feels.
And she said, look, the biggest issue I have is impulse buying.
Yeah.
So if she could just stop that and take a day or a week and then come back to it, that would really help, I think, in this category.
You know what I heard this morning on the radio too? Many Americans this holiday season, as they go shopping, they're still paying off credit cards from a year ago holidays.
Yes.
So that's an example of living beyond your means, right?
Exactly. You got to live below your means. You got to, unfortunately, budget, and that gets you on the path towards building wealth, which is really what we're all trying to do here.
Absolutely. And I love that, because that goes into our second point of building wealth and building that financial security. So one day you don't have to work anymore. I mean, you've got to be really smart when it comes to retirement. Don't wait.
Exactly. So waiting to start saving has devastating consequences. You've got to get started now. The example I have, I think we're going to put it on the screen potentially, but if you start saving in your 20s, you only need to save about $400 a month to retire comfortably and be a millionaire. If you wait till your 50s, that $400 turns into $4,000.
Oh, man.
Think about that.
Whoa.
You have to save $4,000 a month to be able to achieve that same goal. So the action item here, start now with any amount.
You know, that's a great tip. $400 a month in your 20s turns into $1 million by the time you reach retirement age. Hey, let's talk about another common mistake people make. That is overbuying when it comes to our homes. Homes are a great investment unless you buy a home that is too expensive. You can't afford it.
Right. Yeah. And I see this all the time with young folks when they buy their first home, young couples, they buy too much home too quick.
They buy their dream house.
Right. They get caught up in it, and then all of a sudden their house poor with zero cash flow. And remember, cash flow is what's critical so you can save and be able to achieve those financial goals. So my tip here is try not to buy anything more than 3 times your income. So if you make $100,000, you don't want to be buying a house that's $300,000 or more.
Right.
That's a good rule of thumb.
Yeah.
Okay, and when it comes to our investments, you also recommend sort of diversifying, right? So you're not owning too much of one thing?
Yeah, exactly. This again, can have devastating consequences if you have most of your portfolio in one company. We have a great example here in Houston, of course, with Enron when that all went down. But see, GE, that's a great example this year. That's the bluest of the blue chip companies. That's down over 40% year to date for a number of reasons. If you have $1 million in GE, you now have $600,000.
Wow.
So diversify, diversify, diversify.
It's great advice. You always have it. Trevor, thank you so much for stopping by. Happy Thanksgiving.
Yes, happy Thanksgiving to y'all.
And sorry about that turkey sound effect. It scares us too.
I know.
For more info on investing or financial advice, there it goes again, with Trevor and the Shikiba Group, you can always visit their website, theshikibagroup.com. He knows his stuff, so pay him a visit.
Thanks.
Thanks, Trevor.